Silver Grass College. We didn't know it was. My dad was all right. I'm trying to get something. He stole it from me. I didn't know it was not working. A lot of people were going for Instagram. What the hell were you guys looking at? There's pictures of them, but.
Anybody could appreciate it too. Would you trade that money by this one?
No, actually, you know what you traded it? He bought a whole thing, which was a copy. I still got it. It looks just like the map.
That was the one that one on one.
This one.
That one.
Gotta get my other people. Thank you.
I invite you to stand and join in as we sing our processional hymn, Come Christians, Join to Sing.
Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome to First Christian Church. We are so excited to have this festival this year. This is the first time that we've been able to hold the Community Choir Festival at First Christian Church, so that's especially exciting, not just in the new building, but at our church. So I would introduce our wonderful director today. His name is Dr. Gregory Parker. Greg and I served on the faculty at Choan together for several years and got to know each other quite well. He has led choral tours throughout Eastern North Carolina, throughout the United States, and overseas, and I was privileged to get to go on some of those tours, one of which was to Italy and one to Ireland, and we just had a grand time, and the students sang all different places at churches. They even sang at St. Patrick's Cathedral in Ireland. And they even visited a mission when we were in Ireland. And so it was not only a time of singing, but it was a time of spiritual growth as well. Gosh, what else can I say? He is the chair of the department at Washington and Lee University in Lexington, Virginia. And we are just very privileged and grateful that he decided to come and do this for us. Now, I do need to tell you that you were invited to stand for all of the hymns except for one, and that is When I Survey the Wondrous Cross, and you may be seated for that. So this is a test to see if you remember when to stand and when to sit. And before we continue, I'm going to ask Dr. Greg Barmer to lead us in prayer.
Pray with me, please. Lord, we gather in your name. God, our Father, God, our holy brother, and God, our holy companion. And we're careful, Lord, to recognize your lordship among us. We're careful to recognize your presence here with us. Be present, O Lord, and may we know your presence. May we hear your word. May we know your message. And may we be moved not just by beauty, but by the sacredness of that beauty when offered for holy reasons, for your glory and for your purpose. So ordain our gathering, ordain our music and our voices and the music that's produced today so that you are honored and glorified among us here in this town. In the holy name of Christ, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Good afternoon. It's a delight to be back in North Carolina, having spent 9 great years up in Murfreesboro. They pronounce it Muffsboro. Being a Southerner, I'm well aware with the economy of syllables. Don't spend time on a syllable if you don't have to. So I'm a missionary to the Virginians now. Lived in scenic Lexington for 4 years, but have been privileged in all 4 of those years to be invited back to the land of the longleaf pine to do something like this. And I come every time I get a chance because I do love coming back here. I've had a great time with these wonderful singers. And just now, as we sang that great hymn, one of the oldest texts that we have on the program today, goes back many centuries into another language, we are reminded that Jesus was a gift for all mankind. Lord of the nations, not just Lord of one nation or Lord of one people group, but of all. Look at all the different people. Look at all the different choir robes. It's a beautiful picture of how God loves us all. We want to sing a couple of numbers that help us think about that sacrifice as we come. We're in the season of Lent, and the Holy Week observances are not far away. And so we want to sing this really lovely piece called "And No Bird Sang." And then that will be followed with a great hymn. We'll do that great hymn after that, right? When I survey the wondrous cross. And so in those two things, I want you to just think about the sacrifice of our Lord. And no bird sang. I told the choir yesterday, I spent some time looking through the Bible, and I couldn't find any biblical reference for that, birds not singing at the crucifixion. But we can only assume that the whole idea there is all of nature stood silent in that moment when the Creator of the universe deigned to become one of us and die on a cross, so that you and I might know the joys of eternity. So listen carefully as we sing "And No Bird Sang," and then pour your soul into the singing of "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross." So Solomon's words ring true. It's not in the seeking of pleasures or the accumulating of wealth, because all that is vain. You really can't take it with you. There's one thing you will take with you. Your soul. That's all you're going to have. When it's all said and done, you fold up this tent, you're going to go one way or the other. We live because God wanted a friend, and He created us to be His eternal friend. Doesn't that make you feel good? So tomorrow morning when you get up and you go to work, and that person that drives you crazy, to love our God is the reason we live. Lord, I want to be a Christian. Great old song just says that, and then it says, I want to be like Jesus, which is saying a lot, and I want to be more loving in my heart. Oh, that we will be that kind of folks when we leave here today. The world needs that. Our communities need that. Our nation needs that. We are needed to be salt and light and love for our fellow men. Listen, sing along if you want to. You won't mess us up. Did you know that when you sing in a choir, it doesn't take very long when you're singing together for your heartbeat to sync up with the people around you? Have you heard about this? It's true. Google it. That's in the world of academia, you don't send them to encyclopedias anymore. You send them to the internet. They go whether you send them or not. And they come back sometimes with spurious things. But this is true. This is absolutely true. There's been a lot of research done that when you sing together, your heartbeat synchronizes with the people you sing with. It's because you breathe at the same times. That's if you want to know the science, I mean, that is largely because you take breaths at the same time and you're singing at certain tempos and your heart is just a tempo meter. But it's a wonderful thing. That's why we like to sing. God made us to sing. God made us to make music. Every culture. I teach a class at Washington and Lee on non-Western European musical cultures. Music that comes from everywhere that isn't Italy and Germany and France and England. You know, there are other parts of the world that make music. Every culture on the planet, you can go anywhere on this planet, and they'll be making music. The Ba'aka people of the Central African Republic get together in their little communities. They live nomadically in just little huts that they can travel around with, but they live in the forest. And they begin to sing, and they don't sing songs with words. They sing with what's called vocables, or just non-texted syllables. And it's polyphonic singing, and it layers on top of each other, and on top of each other, and on top of each other. And as they do that, you know why they do it? Because it builds community as they sing together. They're all singing their own line, but they're all singing together. And they also believe it connects them to their surroundings as the sound bounces off of the trees and the rocks and the hills and the valleys. They feel that they are connected to their world. Singing connects us. The biggest choir you'll ever direct, I was told in my philosophy of church music class when I was a graduate student, is your congregation. You sang well. You have every reason to sing. They have every reason to sing. One faith we have, one hope, Jesus Christ, one Lord, our God and Father of us all. So take the memory of this time where your community comes together, where we worship in slightly different ways. We would differ on doctrine. But we must agree on the supremacy of Jesus Christ and of his shed blood for us and the rich, wonderful duty that is ours to just share that love with somebody else along life's way. Listen as we sing.
Thank you.
Let's stand and sing our final hymn.
Thank you. Thank you.